Hello and welcome to the Cinemates chat show powered by the Bsss College. I am Mohammed Anzar and today we are going to discuss about the imperativeness of communicative English in a student's life. And to discuss this topic, we have the language cell in charge of our college, Piyush sir.
Thank you for coming, sir.
Thank you, sir.
And welcome to the show. So it is, you have been associated with English literature since English communicative language since a very, very long time. So would you like to tell us, how did you start it? What are your roots?
First of all, I would like to say that my journey began around 16 and a half years ago when I started learning Queen's English. And since then, she became the queen of my heart.
Ah, lovely.
A food of my everyday life. It's because I found that English is very, very imperative when it comes to targeting the youth of our society. In my 16 and a half years of experience, I have been to multiple places and targeted many different backgrounds that the people had at that time. And they demanded English in a very, very different way. They wanted English to be available like a global language, used as a global language of workplace. So I found that English provides a very high quality and work-focused skills. And thereby, I believe it helps a youth in many, many different ways. For example, it makes the recruitment process of the youth very easy. It helps to boost up the employability rate of the student. If the student want to go for any future multinational companies or even want to work in a domestic fields in and around the town.
So, yeah. So how has your experience been in the language lab for college?
Well, I think it's wonderful and rather magical for me to act as a language lab instructor of our college. So far, there has been multiple times where I was exposed to many different semesters which are made available by the management to me, and so far I believe I have lived up to the expectations of the management. So far, I found that the youth wanted to prepare themselves for cracking up the interviews, especially whatever campus recruitments make a visit to the college. So they tend to ask for some group discussions or personal interviews. So I sometimes try to help them with some HR questions, which are very, very fruitful in the immediate future of these students.
Alright, yes. So my next question is a very general. Mm-hmm. How important or how imperative is the communicative English in today's world?
So far, I would like to take four different levels, which makes this basic level of English to go global, in fact, and that is done through reading, writing, listening and speaking.
Exactly.
One needs to have mastery over these four levels so that you can ask for a very good package if you want to go for some company, or there can be some other areas where it could be very, very beneficial for your overall personal as well as professional lives.
I see. So my next question is about this very special and very extensive course which our college offers, that is the back course. So I would like to ask you, what is back course and how will it help anyone or any student in their future prospects?
Precisely, back or Bsss English certificate is an international language testing system. Under it, we have got four different modules: reading, writing, listening and speaking. And a candidate has to go for a specific band to score the maximum marks so that you could be tested at the European level. So these international language testing systems become a true benchmark of competence for all those who want to immigrate to some foreign countries such as US and UK. And at the same time, there can be the other features available where you can go for the academic part of the language as well. So these two different criterias help a candidate to have very, very effective communication.
So a lot of people, a lot of journal or the masses do not distinguish between the literature and the communicative English. Mm-hmm. Would you like to tell us the difference between these two?
Well, there is a world of difference, I believe, when it comes to the literary part of the language. The literary part is actually more syllabus-centric language, where we have got very refined words, the syntaxing of the language, and the way how the sentences need to be constructed. But when it comes to communicative language, we have got a vast arena of the use of the vocabulary with us, and one needs to master how to fix that specific or peculiar words so that it can be used for constructing up the sentences or the statements. So this is what the major difference I find among these two criteria.
So my next question is about, we see that there are people who have this low self-esteem because they cannot have or speak good English language. Mm-hmm. So I would like to ask you, mm-hmm. how to learn to speak better English and correct English?
I would like to bring this under the portfolio of effective communication, because effective communication is very crucial to the overall functioning of any organization. So if you're taking English as a hub, you find that there is a complex network of communication. So one has to be very good at taking or attending up the telephone calls, English use for internet communication purposes. One has to deal with letter writings and emails, where most of our denizens of our city are very poor at. So that's what's the duty of the master trainers, to train them into very peculiar writing skills. And at the same time,
I'm really sorry to interject. I'm really sorry to interject. You just choose that we need a lot of master trainers. For let's just take in the context of our city, Bhopal. Do you think there are enough master trainers of English communicative language, or do they have the quality to teach these students correctly?
I'm afraid not. It's because when it comes to English hospitality, most of the master trainers may be ill aware, or are not
fully aware.
Yeah, they're not abreast of what exactly does the youth of today demands. And at the same time, they should not forget that it's not an old and conventional methods of just teaching in the class or lecturing a student. It won't do the work exactly what the youth demands. So there should be a very, very positive approach, and it has to be more constructive.
But we are lucky to have you, that we have such a great English master in our
college. The pleasure is
all mine, yes. No, sir, the pleasure is all ours, yes. To be honest. And so my final question to you is that there is a misconception among the people that the people who are successful in speaking correct English with correct grammar, with correct syllables and imps and all that, other people tend to think that they are very proudy. So do you think it is correct?
Well, in this context, I would like to say that I'm so much motivated by the desire of making or turning this city to be very, very hospitable with its youth. And that brings a lot of ease of English communication. So when you have such suppleness and so much of smoothness, you create an ideal environment for new generations, and those new generations can live and work effectively. So that's what I believe, because I believe in one part which I always had it since I began my journey of English language and to act as an English teacher, to have S, C and C, which is called as secure, comfortable and convenient.
That's wonderful.
As long as we go with this particular motto in our life, I think English will be like a kid's fun. It won't be a very difficult language, especially for those who belong to a very...
Non-English background.
Non-English background, who are from the very challenging background, who take only Hindi as a mother tongue and have had major inconvenience of using words and sentences.
All right. Yes. It's a pleasure meeting you, sir.
Yeah, the pleasure is all mine. Thank you so much.